Okay, another type of call that I really like to use is, today they're kind of known as pot calls. And because it has, it's built in a little pot frame. This particular call is, it's glass over slate. And there's a lot of pot calls on the market, but this happens to be one of my favorites. And this one here is very, very versatile. And what I like about it is a glass pot call tends to be higher pitched, so it reaches out further. It has a little bit more versatility to it as far as getting loud and getting quiet. The slate side of it, and any slate pot call for that matter, is typically, it's more subtle, and it's more like close-in calling, in my opinion. And I'll demonstrate it here what I mean. Like you can do a tree call on the slate side of this call, or any slate call for that matter, and get really soft. It's really good for clucks and purrs. And then on a glass type surface, you can get really high pitched, crank on it real hard, use it for location, kind of like a, you know, the long box call that I just talked about. So here's an example of a classic hen yelp that you're going to use when you're hunting turkeys. Just 5, 6, 7 yelps. You can mix it in with a few cuts. So that's on the glass surface. Now, if I turn this over, and again, this is a dual surface call, but if you have a slate type pop call, it's going to be a little softer. Do clucks and purrs. You got to remember, turkeys don't run through the woods just yelping their heads off all the time. There's a lot of misconception about that. Turkey flies down in the morning, they're typically more vocal when they first hit the ground, and then they're just walking through the woods and they're scratching and they're clucking and purring, a lot of little soft, subtle stuff like this. That's a cluck and a purr. And that's what they do that when they're just moving throughout the day, just feeding, just soft, subtle clucks and purrs. So if you want to get on this call, our glass call, to use it for location, you can get really super aggressive. And I'm going to change strikers here. This one has a carbon tip, and I'll show you a little bit of versatility, and that's going to get a lot louder. And that's carbon striker over a glass surface. Well, a couple things to consider on a pot type call, be it slate, glass, and I've got another one I'll show you here in a minute that's aluminum, is you can get a variety of sounds out of them because you can use different types of strikers. Now, I've got two here. Now, this one happens to be Purple Heart wood, and this one is basically a carbon arrow, and it's, I guess it's glued onto this wood handle here. So. The carbon striker is going to give you the high pitch shrill. It cuts good. You're going to get more subtle, soft stuff with a wooden striker. And the wooden striker is going to be soft and subtle both on glass and on slate. So you can. And then you can turn it over in a slate call or use another type slate call. It's way easier to get soft and subtle on a wooden type striker than it is a carbon tip type striker. No, here's another type pot call, and this one is aluminum, and this call is pretty special to me. Mark Drury gave me this call, oh gosh, years and years ago. It was when he had Mad Calls. It's one of the first ones he produced to give it to me, and I've been using it for years and years, killed a lot of turkeys with it. This is a full aluminum surface, and I use it with the same type strikers I use on slate. This one happens to be Purple Heart. High pitch. That's the way the call was built, to be higher pitched than slate or glass. That's your cutting. Yelping. And it's super high pitched. It's a great location call. And you can tone it down too when you're, you know, in close proximity to a turkey. But this aluminum surface is really shrill, reaches out. It's another good option to go along with slate and or glass. You know, the basics of running a pot call is, there's a misconception when using these type of calls that you call in the center of the call. You can see how I've got this call sanded. In all my friction calls are this way. I'm always gonna call up on the edge, probably around 1 o'clock on the call, and not far down from the edge of the pot. So I'll give you an example, and it's basically gonna be, I'm gonna hold my striker on a little bit of an angle, not straight up and down, a little bit of an angle, and I'm gonna make little short C shapes just for a basic yelp. Now, the more pressure I put on it, the louder it's gonna get. And you'll feel the call, we have a term called, you'll feel it turn over as it's making a yelp. You'll feel it in the striker, actually. You can feel the yelp coming off the striker, and that's your basic yelp. And your clucks and purrs, I'm gonna do my clucking on the slate side of this particular call. You're just basically gonna make a little short, just a little short strike. And then cluck and purr, you're gonna drag the striker. And it's something, you gotta feel your friction call out, so you'll learn how much pressure to put on it to make a purr. But here's your cluck. That's your purring. And again, if you press too hard, it'll get louder, but you just want a kind of a moderate amount of pressure to make that purr. C-shaped yelps, straight pull on your clucks, and drag it to make your purrs. That's the basics of a pot call. And you can get, again, you can get more aggressive with it when you put more pressure on it and just speed it up, like if you want to do some cutting. Mix it in with some yelping. But same concept, you just a little C shape up towards the side of the call. You just have to play with the call and kind of figure out where the sweet spot is on the call, because there's gonna be spots on this call that's gonna have a little bit more of a sweeter sound, and where the striker bites a little bit better than it does in other parts of the call. Main thing about turkey calling is keep your rhythm consistent. You'll hear guys call and they just bap, 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 bap. A turkey's rhythm is always the same. Pop, 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 pop. And that's just something that comes with time, and you'll feel it out. But the rhythm is super important. Good old turkey rhythm. One thing to consider on a pot style call too is the pressure that you put on the striker. You're gonna hold that striker on a little bit of an angle, but just the pressure part of it is something you're just gonna have to feel out. If you call real light, you'll be able to tell that the tone doesn't sound as good as you put a little bit of moderate pressure, and it depends on the surface of the call as well. So, and then the amount of pressure you put on the side of your hand laying on the pot. You're not gonna push down real hard. Just lay your hand on the side, lightly grip the call in your hand. You don't have to squeeze it real tight because it will change the tone. And there's holes in the bottom of this particular call where the sound comes out. So a lot of times a lot of calls are built that way, when I wanna tone it down, I normally hold the call like this, where there's a lot of air space under my fingers. But if I wanna tone it down and call soft, I'll lay it in my hand, right in the palm, where I'm kind of blocking off those holes to where I can get real soft with it. So it's a big game of feel. Just take your time, do a lot of practicing. The C shape, when you do a C, it makes the call yelp better than scratching back and forth, straight back and forth. There's a lot of calls you can just go straight back and forth. You'll notice it's not yelping as good as when I... You can tell it's a little sweeter yelp when you're doing that C shape. So just a game of feel. Just takes a little bit of time, a little bit of practice, but you'll figure it out. It's not hard to do. You know, when you talk about the variety of calls that's out there today, I've been turkey hunting a lot of years, and I've kind of, the way I use these calls and the way I look at them is when I'm in the woods, like we are today, I don't call real loud. I call mostly soft and subtle. When I'm out in a field situation or if it's windy, I'm gonna call harder and louder and more high-pitched. When I'm in the woods, like I might use a glass call or that long box call to locate a turkey when I'm looking for a turkey. Like if I'm on a county road, driving down the road trying to strike a bird, or if I'm out in the middle of a wide open field, cutting across the field and I'm trying to locate a turkey, I'm gonna use something that's super high-pitched and reaches out to locate a turkey at a distance. Once I get into the woods, I don't call very loud. I never have been a real aggressive caller in the timber. I like to just be subtle like a real turkey. I mean, turkeys just don't run through the woods, as I mentioned before, and yelping and cutting real loud all the time. They do it at times, but most of the time it's soft and subtle, and that's what I want to emulate.